author of Soul Shift, and I was really honored to meet him. And one of the first things he says to me is, I love the Lost Tweets of Jesus. So I'm just like, oh, great, that's what I'm known for. I meshed them together and wrote Love Bites. The fate of everyone who's ever been bitten by a vampire. Mm. And so that had a Rob Bell vampire and a Mark Driscoll werewolf, working together. So anyway, that was that. So a book announced on my blog will be my April 1st book release. Yeah. I won't say it's an April Fool's prank, but if anyone asks me, yes, it is an April Fool's prank. But anyway, I'm working on this book called, this ebook called Divided We Unite. And, it's all about just practical thoughts on unity, because I think that, you know, we kind of hit two extremes where we're either like, we just kind of give up on unity, it's never going to happen, or we're like, we're trying to like bring everybody together, then we all come together and we all like,
in the book,
once we acknowledge that, where do we move forward from there?
Right.
You know, what's the next step? Because we have real divisions. And so, as far as ebooks go, I'm experimenting with that. And I'm also going to experiment with a promotion, idea where I'm going to just give it to everyone who's on my email list, everyone who's ever left a comment on my blog. You're going to be receiving an email from me with the book, and I'm just going to see what happens. Just kind of put it out there, give it to a bunch of people, and probably stick it up on Amazon for $1. And if people buy it, great. And if not, I'll try something different next time.
Yeah, this is actually the inaugural time that I'm like really mentioning this in public. So I've been saving this for the Ninja interview.
So. So here's my deal. Like I started out as a complementarian, went to seminary, and through a variety of things, I've written about it a lot in my blog, I ended up becoming an
egalitarian. Either side of this debate,
and this is something that Rachel Held Evans brings up, but I think that people miss it because they find the way her project is presented, they find it too gimmicky.
Yeah.
Which I think she's done a good job. I just think it's misunderstood. It's an easily misunderstood.
Either
project.
Side's going to say,
well, some part of scripture doesn't quite line up. Mm-hmm. And, the problem I run into is that a lot of complementarians, especially just online, when we're both just trying to defend our ground, we want to just be right. And they say, I've got scripture on my side, what do you have? And it's like, well, I've got scripture too. Like, we set up an absolute standard in violation of what God had already revealed in the Old Testament. And, the typical response of complementarians to me, and this is one that I used to use myself, is that, well, that was just an exception, it was a crisis, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, right.
And it's like, well, God sinned then, like, God did something wrong, like any other time that you would say God makes an exception about anything else would be a problem, but
yeah.
With women, it's like, God just kind of winked it. Creating a place on my blog where women can share their stories. And so that's what we're going to start doing in January. I think it's, I forget the exact date now. I should have had this, but mid-January.
Mm-hmm.
Sarah Bessie from Emerging Mummy is going to do the first post.
Okay, yeah.
Sharing a story. It might be her story. It might be a story about someone else that she knows who impacted her. And then after that, we'll have Jamie, the very worst missionary, after her. So, and then I've got a bunch of other people I'm working on scheduling. So. Day, and then for 2 weeks after that, Coffeehouse Theology will be available as a $2.99 ebook.
Okay, cool.
Through Nav Press. Nav Press will be dropping the price for 2 weeks. And then for now through January, the end of January, basically, my book, Path to Publishing, is also 99 cents.
Good.
So as an ebook,
yeah.
You want the hardback book, yeah, shell out like 12 bucks.
Yeah, again, thanks so much, Ed, and I really appreciate this, and I hope that it'll get out there and generate some good buzz for your projects.
Awesome. Merry Christmas.
You too. Merry Christmas. Bye.
Bye-bye.